direct your focus and your attention in your Christian life and in the world. Listen to me. God is no respecter of persons. God is not a partial God. God does not show favoritism. And I wonder how Christians and some people tend to worship God, who is not a respecter of persons, and yet in and of themselves, they show partiality. James, in James chapter 2, says that he raises an argument and says that we should hold forth the faith of Christ without partiality. And he raises an argument that suppose a man enters your house, enters an assembly, enters the church, and the man is dressed in fine apparel. And another man, suppose he is poor, and you tell the rich man or the one dressed in fine apparel to sit at a good place, and you tell the one dressed poorly to sit at your footstool, are you not being partial? Are you not being partial? I want to ask you a question. Do you show favoritism? Are you partial or are you fair? With what the Lord has blessed you with, where you are in life, are you fair or are you partial? Do you treat people based on their tribe? Do you treat people based on their sex and gender? Do you treat people based on the work they do? Do you treat people based on where they come from? Do you treat people based on the color of their skin? Are you partial? Don't be, because God is not. There is no reward for favoritism. There is no reward for partiality. It will not take you anywhere. See, human beings are not materials. Human beings are not inanimate objects to be treated anyhow. The Bible says that we should love our neighbor as ourselves. With the same love you have for yourself, extend that love to others, whether they come from your family or not, whether they are of the same tribe with you or not. How can you call yourself a Christian and still be ethnocentric? How can you think that you are better than somebody based on the tribe you come from? Christianity is not about partiality. For in the kingdom of God, there is neither Jew nor Gentile. You see, the apostle Peter realized it quite very late. When he met Cornelius, Cornelius told him that I was in prayer and the Lord appeared to me. And the Lord told me to send for you have something for me. And when Peter heard this, he said, it is now that I realize that God is not a respecter of persons. You see, maybe you don't know, but the person next to you is the same as you. The person next to you is the same as you. Treat people as human beings. Don't treat people as objects. Don't treat people as positions. Position changes. Time changes. Situation changes. But when time and position and situation changes, human beings remain human beings. That is why you have to treat that brother and that sister as a human being. Be kind for nothing. Be good for nothing. Smile for nothing. It won't cost you your lifetime. It will cost you an hour of your life just to smile and just be good to others. This is a simple message I want to bring to your attention. God is not a respecter of persons. If you claim to worship God, no matter the kind of religion you are in, then you ought to not be partial. Let's extend a loving hand to the society, to our brothers, to the needy. For God is not a respecter of persons. And as you extend your hand to stretch forth a fair and a loving hand unto others, the Lord is opening up heavens and He's pouring down blessings upon you. Refuse to be partial. Refuse to show favoritism. For God is not a respecter of persons. The Lord bless you.